saddest moments in one's life is when he has to flee his home, land, and people to survive with his religious belief. It gets even harder when those you run from are of the same religion or belief, but have different views, thoughts, or ideas than you do. While Egypt's eastern desert is very famous for its several well-known monasteries, including that of Saint Anthony and Saint Paul, Egypt's western oasis served both as a remote haven for early Christians and Kharga specifically, as a place where Christian church leaders were sometimes banished when their views were considered to be unacceptable. Today, we may find some of Egypt's earliest Christian monuments in the remote regions, and because of the dry climate, often in a decent state of preservation. Qasr al-Bagawet, necropolis of al-Bagawet, is one of the world's best preserved early Christian cemeteries. Cascading down the southern foothills of Jabal al-Tir are the desert brown, domed mausoleums of one of the earliest and best preserved Christian cemeteries in the world, Bagawet. Called the Mountain of the Birds, Jabal al-Tir is situated about 8 kilometers north of Qasr al-Kharga, the capital of this oasis. It is about 2 kilometers north of the Bagawet Cemetery. A visit here should not be taken without the aid of a guide, as the route and the tale are complicated. Found graffiti and inscriptions dating to as early as prehistoric times. However, on the western side, a path leads to the top of the mountain through a cave. And here, Coptic paintings, prayers, and invocations dating from the 4th, 5th, and 10th centuries may still be found. These inscriptions, which include Demotic and Greek script, were mostly left by hermits who lived in the surrounding caves and can be identified by a cross. At the top of this mountain, we find the Cave of Mary, obviously a sacred site during the Christian era. There is considerable graffiti, including some that predate the Christian era. But among the etchings is a painting of the Madonna and Child, along with a prayer in alternating red and yellow lines. Bagawet is the Christian necropolis of the ancient town of Hibis, in use perhaps as early as the 2nd century through the 6th or 7th century AD. It provides considerable information about early Christian burial practices in Egypt and the relative wealth of the town of Hibis during the late Roman and Byzantine periods, or the late 3rd through the mid-7th century AD. The cemetery preserves 263 mud brick tomb chapels. Most are single rooms with flat, domed or barrel vaulted roofs. A few have multiple rooms. The facades of most chapels are decorated with arches, niches, and engaged columns, others with crosses or the crux and satyr, ankh. There is evidence of plaster and some paint on the exterior of many tombs. Interiors are decorated with narrative scenes, symbols, and architectural ornament. Almost all painted decoration is lost. The graves are either flat, oblong hollows cut into the ground, some with low superstructures of brick or quarry stone, or subterranean pits accessible by a vertical shaft, sometimes containing several chambers. Most contain multiple burials. The elaborate tomb chapels were used for rituals commemorating the dead. Scattered among the mausoleums are hundreds of pit graves, aligned on an east-west axis. Each has a low superstructure, either rectangular in form with outer courses of mud brick and a filling of gravel or rubble, or an oval mound of loose stones covered with a coating of mud plaster over the mouth of the grave. Graves are usually provided with sandstone head and footstones. The headstone bore the name of the deceased, which was engraved into the stone itself or into mud plaster with which the stone had been covered. The cemetery of Begawet is located about a kilometer north of the Temple of Hebes and about 3 kilometers to the north of the city of Al Kharga, behind the Temple of Hebes. This cemetery got its name from its style of architecture, as most of the tombs there were constructed in the form of domes, or Al Qabawet in Arabic, which transformed afterwards into Begawet. This cemetery hosts one of the most important and most ancient Christian churches in the whole world. The cemetery dates back to a period ranging from the 2nd to the 7th century AD, when the Christians escaping from northern Egypt resorted to the Kharga oasis. The necropolis covers an area of about 500 meters in length and 200 meters wide. The main entrance to Al Begawet is at the south side. There are some 263 chapels or shrines located in the necropolis that have been built in 8 distinguishable groups. The main church in the center of the necropolis on the northern edge is a church dating back to the 5th century AD. It is regarded as one of the oldest churches in Egypt and commands a grand view of the necropolis. It is the largest of the structures to be found here. The Chapel of the Exodus. Situated behind a group of chapels located on the central ridge in the northern part of the necropolis, is the Chapel of the Exodus. It may be considered one of the oldest Christian chapels in the necropolis, with paintings attributable to the first half of the 4th century. Yet, there is very little Christian to be found here, as most of the interior is painted with scenes from the Old Testament. It takes its name from the paintings of Moses, leading the Israelites from Egypt. Moses and Sinai. The Egyptian king and his army. Noah's Ark. Adam and Eve. Daniel in the lion's den. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the furnace. The sacrifices of Abraham. Jonah in the whale. Jonah out of the whale. Rebecca at the well. Job in a chair. Job suffering. Susanna and Jermaine at the temple. Sarah in prayer. Only a few scenes touch upon Christian topics. The Chapel of Peace. On the western slope of the necropolis, near its entrance, is found the Chapel of Peace. It stands alone and is often simply referred to as the Byzantine Tomb. Its walls are covered in Arabic, Coptic, and Greek graffiti, while the formal decorations are of a pure Byzantine style. Identified in Greek are the names Adam, Eve, Abraham, Isaac, Irene, Daniel, Dikaiosyne, Yusha, Jacob, Noah, the Annunciation of the Virgin Mary, and Paul instructing Saint Thecla. The decorative theme is very similar to those found in Rome at the catacombs and in many early churches throughout Egypt and elsewhere. They may probably be attributed to the 5th and 6th centuries. One typical Egyptian scene within this chapel is a portrayal of Saints Paul and Thecla, who seem to have been very popular saints within this oasis. Also within the necropolis are about 5 other chapels that still have the remains of good paintings, including themes such as Saints Paul and Thecla, the sacrifice of Abraham, and the Phoenix. Christianity was probably introduced to the Kherga oasis in the latter half of the 3rd century or the beginning of the 4th century. There were a number of important early Christian leaders who were banished to the Kherga oasis, especially during the 4th and 5th centuries for a period of years. It is likely that it was more of an isolated enclave of Christians that included both Orthodox and many forms of heterodox Christians. The necropolis of El Begawet at Kherga Oasis is an existing evidence that Egypt has been for a long time across history the place you run to for your freedom of thought, religion, and life.